Hello, CAC church family and friends. My name is Tom Laird, and I'm the executive director with the Christian Counselors Collaborative. This morning, I want to share briefly with you a few recommendations on dealing with stress and anxiety during this pandemic. Wearing face masks, social distancing, and stay-at-home orders really has an impact on even the most optimistic of us. And imagine if you came into this pandemic with an increased anxiety level and an increased stress level. So this morning, I just want to share a few recommendations with you. Number one, acknowledge how you feel. If you're anxious about losing a job, or if you're anxious about paying the bills, if you're fearful about contracting this virus, if you're stressed about being at home, and a lot of especially extrovert folks really are stressed about being at home, or if you're angry about how this whole thing has just played out, or other things, your loss of money in your 401k. If you have any of those emotions, it's very important just to acknowledge how you feel. Don't pretend, don't deny, and don't spiritualize. If you don't know how you feel, and more stereotypically, guys generally are not as aware of how they feel, pray the prayer of Psalm 139, 23 and 24. Search me, O God, know my heart. Try me, know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any hurtful way in me and lead me in the way everlasting. Number two, take time to talk to God and to listen to God related to what you're feeling and thinking. God loves you. He wants to hear what's on your heart and mind. Resist the temptation to keep this to yourself, to avoid, to withdraw related to your feelings and thoughts. God wants to hear what you're feeling. He says in 1 Peter 5:7, cast your cares upon me because I care for you. And secondly, listen to God. C.S. Lewis says, God whispers to us in our pleasures, but shouts to us in our pain. Number three, if you need to talk to someone, it's very important to know that talking to a friend can be very valuable. Now, if you're a strong introvert and you don't really want to do that, that's fine. But most people need to be able to talk to someone about what they're feeling and thinking. A pastor friend recently sent me this quote, and it's actually from Mr. Rogers, and it must have been from his movie, but I really liked it. And it says, anything that is human is mentionable, and anything that is mentionable can be manageable. When we talk about our feelings and thoughts, they become less overwhelming, less upsetting, less scary. The people we can trust with that important talk can let us know that we are not alone. And that's very important during this time. Number four, there's a collective stress for our community, our country, and really the world. Every individual goes through a different level of it, but there's a collective stress. So grant grace to yourself, grant grace to your spouse, grant grace to your children, those you love, because there is an increased stress. And with increased stress, there's a less of a capacity that you had prior to this stress. I saw evidence of this recently when I was at the Giant Eagle. And I saw this sweet elderly woman just sort of losing it on a manager. And it was clearly she was just very stressed out. So grant grace during this time to yourself and your loved ones. Lastly, identify what are things that help me reduce stress? This is very individual specific. You may have some things that help you reduce stress that perhaps really wouldn't help me. But identify what they are for you and utilize them during this time. I'm going to mention very quickly a handful of them that can be helpful. Music can be very wonderful during this time. My wife loves to listen to K-Love. I'm not really as into music as she is, but I will tell you this past Sunday, I must have listened to that Pittsburgh Blessing 15 times, and it really touched my heart. So music would be one idea. Additionally, it's very important during this time to be thankful, to give thanks to God for what it is that you have in your life. Make a mental list. What am I thankful for? Another stress reducer is actually reaching out to people, writing a note, making a meal, indicating to someone you're going to pray for them. These are things that are very helpful because anxiety and stress are very self-referential. So these are very good things to do. One of the pictures I have in my office, the one that I love the most more than my family, beyond my family, is this picture of Jesus laughing. And so another thing to engage in is to look for opportunities to laugh. The scripture says in Proverbs, laughter is medicine for the soul. So if you like good, clean fun, I encourage you to get online and look at some stand-up comedians or just find some way to enjoy laughter during this time. It's Very good. Meditation is the fifth one. And there's about six different forms of meditation in our culture. I'm referring to Christian meditation. So take some time to meditate on the character of God, the promises of God, or the God's creation. Last night, I fell asleep to meditating on "My God will keep in perfect peace him whose mind is stayed on thee." So take some time to meditate. And then lastly, limit exposure to negative input into your mind. Certain social media sites, TV stations, news, limit the exposure. We don't need a regular diet of new people dying every day. It's sad news, but sometimes you have to limit exposure to things that are going to drag you down into anxiety, stress, and fear, and as well into anger, because some shows can make you quite angry. Lastly, let me say, if you're overwhelmed, if you're struggling to just cope through this time, we at the CCC want to help you. So feel free to reach out to us at 855-222-2575, and our intake coordinator would be glad to talk to you during this time. Let me close with a scripture verse that's very meaningful to me, Psalm 27, verses 13 and 14. It says, "I would have despaired unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." Wait for the Lord. Be strong and wait for the Lord. Have a great day serving Christ.
Thank you so much for watching our video. If you wouldn't mind giving us a like, follow, and subscribe on our Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube accounts. Also, a share on Facebook could have a family or friend see this video too. We'd really appreciate that. All this information can be found in the description below or on our website at butlercc.org. We'll see you next time.